welcome everyone. So today's video is a closet tour slash closet Q&A. So I'm gonna show you around my entire closet, and then I also ask you on Instagram about your questions about my closet, my wardrobe, my style, and we're gonna answer them. So I'm gonna start by showing you my entire closet, and then I also ask you on Instagram about your questions about my style, my wardrobe, my closet, and I'm gonna answer them for you. Let me start by telling you that yes, we are currently under my bed. I'm a 22-year-old with a bunk bed. I have a one-room apartment, and it just worked the best for me to have my bed up here, my closet down here. So that is where we're currently at. Also, I don't keep all of my clothing in my closet. I have it pretty much all over the apartment, but this is where I keep pretty much most of my stuff. So let's start by letting me walk you through my entire closet. So starting right here, I have a few bags and then a beautiful scarf, this little suitcase that I also use as a bag. I have some belts right here, pretty much all hung up on this thing. So they're layered, but this is pretty much where I keep all of them. And over here I have all of my dresses. So I have this one that I've shown you before. This is like a long brown one. It has this beautiful like golden detail, so that's cute. This one with a very classic pattern. This one, this like little mini one with the flowers. This beautiful embroidered blouse dress. So gorgeous. This little mini dress. I've got a corduroy mini dress. I have this. This is such a cool sweater dress, so that's cool. This one that I've shown you before, my Alice in Wonderland dress. This one. I also have this gorgeous India-inspired one. So, so, so beautiful. The detailing on it. I have this dress, which is like a long white hippie dress. I love it. It has an open back, and this is actually my graduation dress, so that's pretty cool. This one, got some blouse dresses. Oh, this one is also so cute. This is a striped wrap dress, a long dress, this kind of jean dress with buttons, this beautiful mini dress, mini dresses. So many mini dresses. So many nice patterned mini dresses. This one with this beautiful collar. Yes. And then just some velvet dresses. And then all the way back here, we have some more velvet dresses. And then my nightgowns and kind of like slip dresses. So got them back here. Then we have tank tops over here. So like, I love this one. This is such a cool glam rock shirt. Some crocheted shirts, some short-sleeved blouses. This one, oh, this one is kind of falling off the hanger. Let me fix that. Some short-sleeved blouses, some short-sleeved shirts. Then I, for example, have this one. This is actually from India. So beautiful. It's one of these traditional dress shirt things. Some t-shirts. Not the biggest t-shirt person myself, but I have some pretty funny ones like this one. Disco sucks. I have this one with like the apple that is very Beatles inspired. I also have this beautiful jean blouse that I love. Moving on to long sleeve shirt, I have this 70s disco crop top, a velvet shirt, some beautiful blouses, some more like long sleeve shirts, this embroidered one, this one that is so cool and funky. This one I actually had for years and years, still love it. These are just some of my blouses, some embroidered ones, some very classic ones, some printed ones, some colored one, a jean one, a velvet shirt, and then back here I have this beautiful knitted sweater. Moving on, these are all of my turtlenecks. So I have this one, and then like a bunch of different colored turtlenecks. Back here are just my pants and skirts and everything. I'm gonna go a bit more into depth in the video about it. I have my jackets over here. So like this coat and then a fur coat. This green tweed jacket that I have. Yellow raincoat. Yeah, just some more jackets. This beautiful velvety jacket that I have. This one that I got at a costume drive. Some knitted sweaters, like this one that is so cute. Then I have my vests right here. So these, and also some crocheted ones. And this one that is like such a funky little print. And this one that you could actually wear both sides. So you could either wear it with the jean side out or with this side out. And then this that I more so wear as a shirt, but it's so beautiful. I love the detailing on this. Then I have a mirror right here. Hello, hello. And then over here, I have some shawls that I love, some bags. They're more bags, more bags, more bags, more bags. I got this bag up here that I love. And then just some more scarves and shawls and these gloves that are absolutely gorgeous. Down here I have this bucket full of socks and tights that I absolutely love. And then back here, this little furry thing that you can put on top of your jacket. Then I have my cowboy boots right here. This suitcase is actually filled with my underwear, so we're not gonna look into that, but this is where I keep my underwear and then also my sport clothing. I have some shoes down here. Then I have all of my boots right here, going into some sandals, some other shoes, and then more boots down here. And then I also have some boots in my entryway. I'm not gonna talk too much in depth about my shoes because I just uploaded a shoe collection. I'm gonna link that below for you and probably link it somewhere right now. So you can click on that and watch it if you're interested to see all of my shoes, because that video is almost an hour long and I go very much in depth about every single pair that I have. Above the shoes, I actually have some more beautiful little scarves. So up here I have my hats, not all of them, I kind of keep them all over the apartment, but this is like where the majority of them lives.
I wear hats a lot currently. Yeah, you've probably already seen it. My roots are horrible. The hairdressers are reopening in 2 weeks here. Yeah, but I've been wearing hats a lot lately. Please ignore the mess up here. So we all know the situation. We know that it's important to stay safe. So I don't care that my hair looks like this, but honestly, I can't wait to get it redone. As said before, I asked you guys for your questions on Instagram, and I got so many replies with tons of amazing questions from you. So I kind of tried to put questions together that were asked very frequently. So I took my time and wrote all of your questions down, and now we're gonna start answering them. Starting off, at Bella Angelic asks, how do you arrange your clothing? By colors, tops, vests, etc. Let's see. So as I said before, I kind of organize it by category. So dresses over here, shirts over here, as you saw it. But in the categories, nothing is organized. So I have long sleeve dresses, long dresses, I have mini dresses. It's just everything mixed up. But in general, I just have everything hung up so I can see what I have. And the honest reason for why I have everything hung up is just because I hate folding clothes. I hate, hate, hate it. So now doing laundry is so much easier for me. I just hang everything up and I'm good to go. Next up, I'm gonna combine a few questions just because they all kind of asked for the same answer. So Suzukina, oh, I hope I said that right. But Susanna, she asks, where do you buy your clothes? And then Josh Rocky P, Rocky says, yo, I want a more vintage style and clothes, but I have no idea where to start. Is it all right if I ask for tips? And then at Tommy Walker asks, where do you buy your clothes? Do you have any shopping tips? I love your voice, it's so soothing. Well, first of all, thank you. That's a very kind compliment. I get most of my clothing from thrift stores and online. So I love to shop at eBay. I love to shop from like Poshmark and also Vinted. I don't know if Vinted actually is a international thing, but Depop and places like that are so, so easy. And vintage clothing pretty much can go from $1 to $5,000. So it is an amazing, crazy, overwhelming amount of clothing. So what I like to do is I type something in on eBay, so maybe like 60s mini dress, and then I go on the filter tab and I kind of filter it by price, lowest to highest, and then I start looking. And sometimes it might take you hours and hours and hours to dig through eBay, but honestly, I don't mind doing that. I actually pretty much enjoy doing that. I might listen to some music or put on a podcast and then just scroll through the eBay world. And yeah, that's one of my tips. Another tip, if you go to your local thrift store, to really dig through things. Like, look at every single piece. I have so many things here where I first saw them, I was like, damn, that's not cute. And then as soon as you look closer, you might realize how uniquely beautiful some things are. Another thing, so I, for example, bought this dress. Not the most beautiful, but the fabric is amazing. It has this super cute pocket up here, and it is hand sewn, so you can kind of see the lining is a bit off. So this is still very long. I don't like how this is gonna look, but if I cut it and hem it, this is gonna be such a beautiful little 60s baby doll dress. And that is basically what I do with a lot of things. So I will get them and then just tailor them to fit me perfectly. So if you go to the thrift store, you can just kind of look around and be creative. Also, there are a lot of great companies who make vintage inspired clothing. So even though your stuff might not be actual vintage, it'll probably look like it. So some of my favorite brands are Miracle Eye, The Hippie Shake, Mod Shoes, places like this. I'm gonna just pop a few all around the screen for you right now. But basically, those are amazing places and you might wanna check those out because they also have amazing stuff and you can kind of sort more through it. So if you go to a thrift store, you probably all know that. Like, it might take you hours and you might not found what you came for. So this might be a good option for you. So the next question comes from Jana and she asks, I love your starting a vintage wardrobe video. Thank you, that's kind. Can you show us some more belts? Sure, I have a belt collection. I have them all in this hanger. That's so heavy. So yeah, let me put that back and then show you some of them in detail. So this one is also one of my absolutely favorites. I think it's so gorgeous. It has like this very cute buckle and basically I just love how this part hangs down here. It might look very, it looks super weird with this dress on, but I think you kind of get it. Yeah, so that's another one that I love. I also have this chain belt with these kind of like amber pieces. They're not real amber, but they look like it. And this one is so cute as well. Another one that I wear all the time is this one. It just has this really pretty huge buckle. And then it's kind of beaded with these stars. I think it's so beautiful. This might actually, yeah, this would kind of fit the vibe, even though I just think this dress doesn't really go with any sort of belt. But yeah, that would kind of work. And then some more of my favorites are this one that is kind of made out of these little metal parts. This is so cute with like more of a jeans and band shirt kind of vibe. Such an amazing belt. Next up, I have this black one that I love a lot. It just has this square buckle. As I said, that was a very popular 60s thing. So this one is also very cool. Also great for a glam rock look. This snakeskin one that is originally vintage. It just has a beautiful buckle as well. And then I also have this one. So if you're more into like a Woodstock hippie look, maybe you might want to look for something like this. This is basically just a macrame belt and it's so beautiful. You just tie it around. And then I also love how it looks if you like tie it and then these things kind of hang down. I hope you can see. But I just really love the look of that. I think it's absolutely beautiful. I love this next question. It's by Marmalade Skies Jen. Jen asks, what piece of clothing could you never part with? So I thought about this quite a while and I actually came up with a few different items. So I'm gonna show you now. So one piece of clothing I could never part with is this cute little blouse. This used to be my grandma. So this, she wore it when she was a teenager. So she was a teenager in the 50s. So this is like 70 years old now. It's such a beautiful little blouse shirt. It also has buttons in the back and I just absolutely love this. I had this since I was like 13 or something. So almost 10 years. I had this for a long time and I love to wear it. I still wear it so, so often. It's just a great quality. Also the fabric is super light, so it's great for when it's very hot outside and I could never ever part with this shirt. So I have a few more things that I could never part with. First of all being this one. This is a Rocky Horror Picture Show shirt and I have had this for so many years now because actually my dad took me to see the Rocky Horror Picture Show. It's one of my absolutely favorite movies ever. If you haven't watched it yet, it's amazing. Go and watch it, do yourself a favor. It's a great movie from the 70s. And they do live shows and so I went with my dad when I was like 15 or 16, probably way too young for that sort of entertainment, but it was great. And my dad actually got me this shirt that I had ever since and I absolutely love it. I think it's so beautiful. and I still to this day wear it quite often. These two next things have a very special place in my heart because my great-grandfather actually made them. My great-grandfather was an upholsterer. He has an amazing life story that I'm not gonna dive into deeply, but basically he's one of my biggest inspiration and he sewed me these two items. So the first one being these pajama pants that he actually sewed out of an old bed sheet he had from the 60s. I love them. They're so cute. I think they are amazing. Yeah, and I wear them a lot. I actually also wear them out sometimes because I think they're kind of cool. But yeah, I could never part with these. And then he also made me this skirt. So this skirt is real leather. It's recycled leather though. I said it before, I say it in every video again. I would never buy new leather. I live vegan. I am an absolute animal rights activist. So that would never ever happen for me. But he had this old leather from his days of upholstering. And he made me this skirt out of it. And it is so beautiful. It fits me like a glove. I sometimes kind of fold it up, it's hard to tell, and wear it like this, but I would never shorten it because I feel like maybe in 10 years I don't want to wear like leather mini skirts anymore, but then I can still wear it like this. I also sometimes wear it like this right now. I just think it's an absolutely gorgeous, amazing, beautiful skirt. It's so heavy, great quality. I just love to wear it and I always think of him when I wear it. What are your most worn pieces? What are some staple pieces? So this is also like a combined question because I got it so many times. Let's see, maybe I'll just kind of like look through and then pick out whatever I feel like I wear a lot. Something that I just wear all the time are mini dresses. I, for example, have this one that I wear a lot. Then this one you saw me wear a ton already because I absolutely love it. And then also this one, this is so cute, classic, twiggy look. Absolutely love to wear this one. I talked about it in my starting a 60s and 70s wardrobe, but rompers are great. I have this jean one that I absolutely love and wear. I also love any sort of silky long dress, like this one. I wear this all the time. And I also love to wear mini dresses that are just long sleeves. So this one, for example, is so, so cute. Beautiful orange color. The sleeves are absolutely gorgeous, so cute. Love this, and I wear this a lot too. Another thing that I really love to wear, but more so during the summertime, are like crocheted shirts like this. They were very popular with like the whole Woodstock movement, so these are so cute. Love to wear them. So these are some more of my most worn staple piece items, and these are all of my turtlenecks. I wear them all the time. I wear them everywhere. I'm currently wearing a turtleneck underneath this dress. I just think they're amazing. They're such a great staple piece. As you can see, I have white ones and black ones and gray ones, so some with like amazing prints on them or just some cute little colors, but these are my absolutely most worn items. I also have these few blouses that I wear all the time. So for example, this one that just has beautiful sleeves and these fabric covered buttons that I think are absolutely gorgeous. This one that is embroidered and so, so beautiful. This corduroy one that I wear all the time. And then I also have this one with the little ruffles. I think these are so cute and I wear them all the time. So I just grabbed these from the far back of my closet, but these are like some of my most worn bottoms. First being any sort of shorts like these or these leather ones. And then I also have these jeans ones that I wear all the time. I love to wear shorts also during the winter, during the fall. I just put on some boots and some tights with it and you're always good to go. Something else that I wear all the time are bell bottoms. So like these, for example, these are just dark washed. I cut them because I'm very short, but these are also a great staple piece and I wear them all the time. And another thing that I wear all the time are mini skirts. Obviously, like simple black mini skirts are great, but then I also love anything that is suede because it's very 60s. I, for example, have this brown suede one that comes with this cute little belt. I have this gray suede one with these two pockets. Also super gorgeous, goes great with pretty much every look. And then this is also one of my absolutely favorites, just this purple suede skirt with buttons up here. Some of my most worn jackets are gotta be this one, for example. So groovy, all the 70s vibes. It's gorgeous. I absolutely love the detailing on here and then obviously the whole patchwork look. Then I have this very classic 60s jean jacket that I wear all the time. And then these are some of my most worn vests. So for example, this one that is like such a Beatles look for me. And then this one, very simple but also so beautiful. I have this one that is just kind of patchwork leather. Love to wear this just with jeans and then maybe a turtleneck, so cool. Then I have this one that is beaded, kind of also great for a more chicer look. And then this one that is just also light leather. Also, this one doubles as a dress for me, so sometimes I'll just close it and then just wear it as a dress.
I love this next question, and it's any things that you're still on the lookout for?
Yes,
so many things actually. One thing is a poncho. I would love, love, love to own like a very cool 70s embroidered poncho. That would be amazing. Also, like a granny square jacket would be everything to me, or maybe even a granny square vest. That would be amazing. I'm gonna put pictures up of what I'm kind of picturing so that you have an idea. Also, I'm still looking for a jumpsuit, a long one. Would absolutely love that, especially with like long sleeves and long legs. That would be amazing. Another thing that I'm looking for every single time that I go thrifting is a cape. I would love to own a cape. I think they are so cute. I have found a few ones, but just not the one that I absolutely loved. And I don't really get things unless I really, really love them. So I'm still on the lookout for that. Amy asks, what are your current favorites? Okay, so I have some of my current favorites right here and I'm gonna show you them. First of all, being this amazing hat. This is like all the Janis Joplin vibes for me. I absolutely love it. Also, it's currently winter, so it's very cold and I wear this all the time. Next up is this shirt. I think it's so beautiful. I got it super cheap for like $5 or so at a thrift store last year. Love this. It's so gorgeous. I love the kind of shiny fabric. What I love about this so much is if you wear it with a mini skirt, it's like super preppy mod look, and then you can also kind of be a bit more cool and wear it with like jeans or something, and then it's more of a 70s thing. So I absolutely love this shirt. Also, I'm currently obsessed with this patchwork bag that I just got. I think it's so beautiful. I love how it's like sewn, and I just love anything that's leather and patchwork. And also that it has this wooden part up here, it just makes it so gorgeous for me. I almost forgot this bag. Love it. It's from the 70s originally. So cute, love the embroidery. Beautiful bag, so this is also one of my absolutely favorites right now. Also, this bag, this would be so cute with this look actually. This is so cute. So this is also from the 60s originally. It's this cute little velvet bag. It's so soft and I love the silver crocheting on it. Another thing I'm currently obsessed with is this nightgown that I got. It's so cute, absolutely gorgeous, love this. And the final piece is this dress. It's originally from the 70s. And I just love that it's kind of lower cut and then you have this little shawl part up here. So I just think that's absolutely gorgeous. And another thing is this set. I just love sets. It's this beautiful dress. It's from the 70s. Just kind of has a cutout right here, but then it's like a basic dress. And then it comes with this cute little like jacket. So that is also so gorgeous. Absolutely obsessed with this right now. So this next thing is by Lauren Greyhouse. Lauren sent two replies, but they are kind of one question, so I'm gonna read them out together. So Lauren says, some of your best street finds. Can you explain the entire street find situation? I am from Ohio and I've never seen anyone putting out stuff for free before. Is it a European thing? I don't know if I ever actually talked about this on my YouTube channel. I for sure have talked about this on my Instagram account so often, which is actually linked below if you wanna see daily 60s and 70s content. Follow me on Instagram, I'll also put it on the screen somewhere. But basically, I talk about this quite often that I find stuff in the street. So I don't know if this is a European thing because I've also been in New York for quite a while and I've seen it there a couple of times, but basically, it's when people put out boxes in front of their house and then they just have a little sign with like, for free, take me, something like that. And basically it's just people getting rid of their stuff. And you can just go by and grab those things. And since I spent quite a bit of my free time walking, I just love to listen to music and walk. I see those things all the time. Like, especially when I lived in Berlin, they were all over the place. They're still in a lot of spaces where I live right now, but I am now gonna show you my top finds. So one find that I couldn't believe when I saw it are these shoes. They are actually from the 60s. They are drop dead gorgeous, kind of like metally silver heels, and they were just laying there for free, and so I grabbed them, and yeah, I absolutely love them. I also found this in the street, which is such a beautiful
India inspired bag. I love the little like mirrors up here and all of the detailing. Also, it makes very cute noises when you walk around with it. I don't think this is actually vintage, but I think this is so great if you go for like a Woodstock festival look. I love this bag. Another amazing street find is this little shawl that I just found while I think it was in Berlin. This is so beautiful. You just kind of wear it like this. Absolutely gorgeous. Another find is this jacket that is so cool. Kind of has this shaggy look to it. I love it. It's not the most flattering thing, but it's so cute, I think. So I'm so glad that I found this. I also found so many homeware items on the street, so I'm gonna look around my apartment for a while and just grab some things. So I'll be back in a second. So I just kind of grabbed the things that were in my sight very easy. One being this cute little candle holder. It's out of solid glass and it's so gorgeous. I also found this, and this is such a great find. This is originally from the 60s, like it has a label down here and I googled it. So gorgeous. I think it's like a milk jug or something, but I sometimes use it to water my plants, or I thought about maybe planting a little plant in there. What do you think? That might be cute, right? One of my actual most treasured finds is this watch. This is usually in my kitchen, and it is a ceramic watch. This is from the 70s originally. This also like has a sticker back here, or like the brand, and that's how I could Google it. And this is actually from the same company that I have quite a few items from. So this would sell online for like 50 bucks or something, but I'm not selling it. So basically what I'm trying to say is, if you go outside, if you walk through the street, just walk with your eyes open, you will find so many beautiful things. Oh, and what I just thought about, maybe if that isn't popular in Ohio yet, you could start making it popular. Just put out some things that you don't need anymore, Lauren, and maybe your neighbors will follow, and maybe your neighbors have great stuff. So that might be an idea. So Julia Danisi, I hope I said that right. I'm sorry if I didn't. But Julia says, I'd like to know your most precious treasure. That is hard. I don't think I can put it down to one thing, but I can probably narrow it down to like a couple of things. One being this dress. So this is like a tunic blouse dress. It combines all of the things that I love. It has beautiful crochet, it has beautiful velvet, it is silk. It also has the fabric covered buttons that I love. This is so, so gorgeous. The bag is beautiful. This is from the late 60s originally. This is everything. When I saw this, I fell in love with it and I knew I had to get it, and I wear it so often, it's just great. Another one of my greatest treasures is this dress. I'm sure this was someone's prom dress in the 70s. I absolutely adore the print, these like paisleys and flowers. It is so gorgeous, it fits me like a glove, so absolutely love this. And then maybe you've seen the video that I made in fall about styling and thrifting 60s and 70s stuff. I found this dress. It fits me perfectly. It is so drop-dead gorgeous, so this is absolutely one of my most treasured pieces. I said I wouldn't talk about shoes that much, but these are just, these are my babies. I love them. Talked about them a lot already. These are original 60s lace-up boots. I looked for them all over the place, and when I finally found them, I was just so happy. I wear them all the freaking time, so yeah. These are also one of my absolutely most treasured items. Another one of my favorite finds ever are these gloves. They're also from the 60s originally. They are just leather gloves. They fit me perfectly, and yeah, I was so happy when I found them. And then I have two more pieces. First of all being this leather suede red jacket that is also from the 60s, I believe. It is so beautiful. I actually got this when I was in Budapest. I was there to travel and to visit the festival, and when I found this jacket at a thrift store, I loved it, and it was not expensive at all. So I'm so glad that I got this. And then the final thing is probably this coat. I talked about this coat quite a few times before. It is the absolutely perfect fur coat. As you can see, it fits me like a dream. Like, the sleeves are perfect. Everything is just perfect about this. Yeah, I talked about the whole animal cruelty thing before. As I said, would never, never, ever buy new fur. I live vegan. I absolutely do not support any sort of animal cruelty. But this one I got at a thrift store. It was not expensive at all. I fell in love with it. I knew I had to get it, and I'm so, so glad that I did. So at Cosmic Darling, wow, that's such a beautiful handle.
Great job, that's a beautiful username. But her name is Cass. So Cass asked, what is your favorite vintage item? So well, I've shown you so many beautiful items before, but I feel like I have some more that I love, so I'm gonna show you some more. If you were wondering, pretty much 99% of my wardrobe is vintage. I have very, very little new items. I think most of the modern pieces I have are just still from the time before I started dressing vintage. Pretty much everything that I have by now is either vintage or vintage inspired, so that is pretty cool. I just found four more things that are absolutely on my favorite lists. This dress, so gorgeous, love it. I think it's so beautiful. Then also this dress, this is such a cool 60s mod look. I got this at a thrift store like 1 or 2 years ago and I wear it all the time. This dress, this is just a 70s summer dress. This would be so cool with these boots. Yeah, but I love this. This is also absolutely gorgeous if you like wear a turtleneck underneath it. And then last but not least is this dress. It's kind of hard to tell. Let's see. Maybe if I kind of put it on, it'll do. Yeah, I think now you can see it. So kind of goes on like this. It looks so gorgeous. It has this very low cut back, kind of button it up here. This is also originally from the 70s and I absolutely adore it. Another one of my absolutely most treasured items is this skirt. Well, it's not a full skirt. Basically, that's what you do. So this is from the 60s originally. It is so gorgeous. I love the color. I love the little detailing up front here. This is like such a cute little late 60s vibe. It has an amazing button. And I saw this and I just thought of the Beatles immediately and I knew I had to get it. I remember the lady in the store being very confused about what this actually was. She was like, is that a cape? And I was like, no, you wear it as a skirt. And she was like, wow, that is interesting. I've never seen something like that. So yeah, absolutely love this. So I love this next question. It is, how many pairs of socks and tights do you have? I can't count them, but I can show you. I have some of them in the suitcase, but pretty much most of them I have, let's see, in this bucket. So this is my bucket full of tights and socks. Yeah, I can show you a few of them, but not all of them, because that will like take up a whole nother hour. So I have these tights that have like a print on them, which is a very popular 60s thing. I have a lot of nylon tights in pretty much any shape and color, and also nylon socks. Oh, and then I have a bunch of fishnet stockings. I have white fishnets, black fishnets. They're also amazing. So the final question is by Zorzo Bruma. I'm so sorry. I think I said that horribly wrong. Her name sounds beautiful. I just have no idea how to pronounce it. But the question is, how do you combine different clothes to make an original and nice 60s and 70s look? I really love your style. First of all, thank you so much for the compliment. I thought about making like an entire video about that. Please comment below if you would be interested in seeing that, like an entire how to style 60s and 70s clothing video. We could also do something like styling modern day clothes as 60s and 70s outfit if you're more interested in that. Just comment below telling me what you would be interested in. But what I would recommend you to do is to get like a lot of basics. So you might want to get a black mini skirt, a pair of flare pants, some turtlenecks, a mini dress, and then just work off with accessories. You know what? Let's just style one very easy 60s inspired look and then you maybe kind of get an idea how I built my outfits. So let's just start off with this very basic black mini skirt. So with this, there are a bunch of different shirts that you could wear with it. You could either just put on a very basic turtleneck, that's always a great 60s look. You could put on any sort of blouse like this one, that would also be amazing. Or you could obviously do a long sleeve blouse, maybe something like this. You could just get like a white blouse and then always combine it with everything just because it goes with everything. You could also wear this with a short sleeve shirt. Like I have this one, so these were very popular during the 60s. This is like a knitted shirt. Or if you want to do a bit more of a 70s look, you could put on a blouse like this with like very big sleeves. You could like wear a ton of different belts with it. If you want to go for more like a simple style, maybe just go with a simple colored belt, or you could also go with like something very flashy like this one. So I have this cowboy belt and I think this would also look very cool with it. Then you could just put a vest on top of it. So either, as I said, like a patchwork vest, or this is like a very simple vest that I've shown you before.
You could also do something like this, like a crocheted vest that is more of like a 70s look. And then for shoes, just go with like either ankle boots, sandals, or high boots. And that is basically the look. You could then add like a hat or maybe some gloves and a bag. But basically, just get a few very simple items and then just put it together differently every single day. And I would, so basically what I try to do is work with silhouettes. So like a popular 60s silhouette would be a very classic box cut short dress. So that is a silhouette, and then fill that silhouette with like pieces that you have. Fill it with a mini skirt and like some sort of shirt, a tight shirt, a looser shirt. Another popular silhouette would be a long skirt, so you could just get any sort of long skirt and then just put that together with other things. So I feel like the 60s and 70s were very flashy. You could obviously get stuff like that, but if you're just starting, just put on very basic things, maybe add a scarf to your clothing, add like a hat. Work with accessories and just have fun. Also, always look out for new inspiration. I will link my Pinterest down below. I love Pinterest. I spend like so much time on Pinterest whenever I'm like going somewhere and I'm sitting in a train or sitting in a subway. I just go through my phone, go on Pinterest and look at all of the amazing things, and I just inspire myself with new fashion because that is what makes it exciting for me. Another great tip would be to make stuff yourself. For example, these earrings, these are inspired by earrings that Twiggy wore that had like little disco balls down here, and I looked for them and they were so expensive. Like the only sort of remodeled ones I could find were so expensive, and so I just went to my local craft store and I got these little bubbles for like, I don't know, like 30 cents or something. And then I just attached them to like these little earring things that I still had from an old pair of earrings that broke. So that is like a 30 cent earring. It looks amazing. So just think outside the box, be creative, and the most important thing, have fun with it. So that's it for today's video. There were lots of more questions, but I feel like most of them kind of asked for the same thing, and I feel like I now kind of answered pretty much every question, or at least every topic. If there is still a question you have, just leave a comment below and I will get back to you and answer your question. If you liked the video, I would love you to give it a thumbs up and maybe even share it with a friend. It supports me, it supports the channel, and it would mean the world to me. Subscribe if you want to see more videos. I upload videos 3 times a week, all about 60s and 70s fashion, makeup and lifestyle, music. If you want to see more, just click subscribe to not miss out. I hope you're having an amazing day. Go out, enjoy the sunshine, take yourself some time for you to focus on yourself and your mental health today, and I will see you in the next one. Bye guys!